there's a line that Eric has, where, well, not Eric has, the people, the characters that he interacts with early in the film, two of them say, I don't want to answer that question because you won't respect me for whatever I say. And I think, I wonder if it's a bit like that with working with David, that he just...
No, not at all. I mean, there's certain things. He's got quite a strange sense of humour where, especially in terms of, like, you're so used to doing things as an actor, going, like, can I just have one more take? And, like, and normally Joe's like, of course, just go ahead. David's like, you think you can do it better? And you're just like, yeah, I think. And he's like, well, are you questioning my judgment? And you'd literally just be like, I don't know.
He's inside your mind.
I know, he literally just do all this stuff. He told Emily Hampshire, who's my financial advisor, the jogger, she was so nervous because she did her whole monologue when she gets into the car, did one take, and she was freaking out before. Did one take, and he's like, cool, got it, done. And so she could sort of come up and be like, are you sure? Is that fine? And he's like, yeah. I mean, I just cast you for your body. I'm going to replace your head. And she's literally, for a good 20 minutes afterwards, completely believed him. And I did not, it was just like floored by it. And he's one of those people who never says that he was joking afterwards. So yeah, I have no idea. And it's almost humiliating to ask. But at the same time, it's the nicest person in the world.
So for the first few days, you're just like, David hates me. I
was just terrified. Absolutely terrified.
Was it terrifying on a kind of professional level as well as personal? In terms of, like, it seems like there's no safety net on this. Not only are you doing, you know, one take stuff towards the end of the shoot, but also the script is very, like, you know, the dialogue is transposed from Don DeLillo's book.
Yeah.
Very, I mean, it's impressively kind of articulated, but tough, I'd imagine.
It's quite uncompromising. It's not, there was a review of the movie which was aggressively unlovable. And I was like, and she was like, that should be on the poster. And that was one of the, I was thinking, yeah, that is kind of what it is.
Mm.
But at the same time, I think it really respects the audience for doing that, because it's sort of, it's not an easy film. It's not pandering to anybody. No. I mean, literally, half the people who watch it, like, I have no idea what this is about. I mean, you can really miss the train completely on it. I mean, you're just watching it, the whole movie, going, like, what? What is happening?
Have you figured out the meanings of the inflamed, personally? You're not a personal...
God.
Do you have a favourite bit of dialogue in it? Just, you know, from a... When you're doing the long stuff, the long monologues, is that...
I love the monologue about how to build a stretch limo.
Yeah.
That's one of, like, the... My favorite, like, just in terms of, like, really, really detailed things. You hardly ever have it, like, arbitrary details, and kind of, and having them written as a poem. That's a poem, that thing. Saying, extend the chassis by 24 feet or whatever desired dimension. But they had there's a ton of lines. I love the scene with Samantha Morton. Like, I love all her lines in it. And it's so weird as well, because I've never read any Don DeLillo before. And to have in a movie, like, very prescient, actual, like, philosophical ideas in a, like, relatively mainstream movie, it's so weird. Like, all the future becomes insistent stuff. And also saying, this is a protest against the future. Like, that is exactly what all these protests are.
Yeah.
And to say that, and we had no, like, the Occupy Wall Street stuff came, like, literally round about the day we were shooting it. And
the custard pie. It's weird.
It's so weird.
Cyclist-y in a Cronenbergian way, isn't it? It's like a film in itself.
And especially how almost every single actor who came in was like, I don't know what it's about, I don't know what I'm doing. And then everything a year later is like, every single journalist is like, it's about contemporary society. I'm like, oh, I just thought it was like a comedy, it was really weird. I think pretty much everybody just thought it was really funny.
Yeah.
Like, me and Paul Giamatti especially. I mean, you watch that scene that's like really sad. And we were like pissing ourselves laughing all the time doing it. So, like, who knows?
Your hand got better as well.
Yeah. That was weird. Like, I mean, that stuff, like doing it one take with a stunt in it as well. Like, it's just, it doesn't make any sense.
You didn't get tasered though. Because in the book, you get tasered. Yeah. In the film, no taser.
Yeah, you get tasered on your balls.
Your balls.
Yeah, which I wanted to do that a lot, actually.
And why not? It's insurance issue.
Well, I mean, David that I wanted him to, that I wanted them to tase me, because I saw, like, I looked it up before, like, people getting tased, and I really wanted to do it.
Yeah.
But there's a potential for having a heart attack if you do it.
You don't have to do it for real, though, surely.
Well, I wanted to do it for real. I mean, it would have been quite fun. I mean, how many times are you gonna do that?